What's up, little man? What's happening? What's happening? What's up, guys? This week's vlog is going to be a combination of like 3 days. So we're going to do base Monday, the 14th. We're gonna have some highlights from today, highlights from Wednesday the 16th, which is in the future, and then a couple clips from Saturday. We'll probably bro out, have some fun here with the community. So, Jack and I are gonna get ready to lift. We're just warming up some snatches. You guys will see the highlights of everything. Keep it short, simple, sweet. So yeah.
Yes, come on.
Alright, so we're doing snatch deadlifts, but you guys haven't met Brandon Hobbs yet. Also one of our best friends, also one of our training partners. He's doing Attitude Nation's strength program right now, holy program. But yeah, you'll meet him in a bit. I'll introduce you.
Nice.
All right, guys, this is Brandon. You guys haven't met him yet. He's almost masters, 34 years old, killing it. What weight class are you?
62, 69 kilos.
Depending on if you want to cut. Cool, man. You'll see a lot of this guy. This guy's being a pussy today, but whatever.
Be fine.
All right, see you soon. Vlog Periscope Inception.
It's
right
not
now.
That fancy of a box, but yeah, it's old.
Let me see, hold on. Doing a live Periscope right now. Wait, where's the other? Sick. Four people watching. Crazy!
You're just gonna be like, what is this?
What's up, guys?
Wednesday, September 16th now.
Tight. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby.
Oh, what are you doing?
What? Oi! Nice. Tweedledee and Tweedledum.
What up?
This is Mark. He's a longtime friend, and this is Jeremy, another good friend of ours. They always train together.
These are the two hardest working guys.
Oh, give me a break.
Hardest working guys in here.
Get out of here. We all know that's not true.
Oh, explain what we're doing.
We're going to do 4 rounds of 750 meter rowing. Ryan's going to attack one of his weaknesses today. He's going to hit overhead squats. I believe he's doing 15 of them at 95. One of my weaknesses is deadlift, so I'm going to be doing 10 to 15 at
15, 225. Little outside setup here while the class is going on. 6 o'clock class finishing up. About to get after. I'll see you guys after.
Go, Ryan, last round. Finish out. Come on, get it.
Fuck.
After that, for 4 rounds.
Sucked.
What's up, guys? It's Saturday, the 19th. We are here. I did a workout with another guy, Steven, earlier. It was 20 to 1 of 225 deadlifts. What did we do? Oh, weighted kayaks and wall balls with 25-pound wall ball. So that was good. Warmed up a little bit. Zach came in. We just hit 2 workouts from the competition that we're going to do October 10th. So we did a workout that involved like max effort, shoulder overhead, ground overhead, rowing. Then right after that, we did one that was like a chipper. And then it ended with a barbell complex of 3 front squats, 2 back squats, and 1 overhead squat.
Once the bar leaves the ground, it can't be set back down to finish the complex.
Yeah, so taken from the ground, Zach hit 275, which was legit. I hit 225 and missed 245. Just kind of beat up. Yesterday I did Grace at 225, so my shoulders are pretty wrecked. But right now we're just working on just some static movements while we have the CrossFit Kids class going on inside. So I'll get a couple clips of us doing some benching, some barbell rows, and some strict and kipping overhead or handstand pushups. And then I think Zach will probably hit another workout after that. I don't think I'm going to. I'm honestly feeling it.
Plan today is Fat Fran, but we'll see how we feel after these static movements.
So I'll get some of that on film, and we'll go from there.
Don't go too heavy.
Zach's right now at the end of a 10-minute Aerodyne max effort calorie test. You see the clock in the background. Let's go, come on, 12 seconds. Three, two, one, time. .190, 3.5 miles, and a dead person. What's up, guys? About to do a photo shoot with Killing Gravity, and this is before. Hold on. After.
One facing forward, one facing backwards.
Yeah, I like that. That's really good. The back. So. What? How heavy does that? Okay, Jay, your turn.
Cool. All right, guys. So these last couple weeks we've been doing really well through the vlogs, but we're finally going to take a step back and kind of answer some questions that we've had throughout the gym and community, I guess, and what everyone wants to know.
Brandon's interrupting,
that's fine. But people wanted to know about our nutrition habits. I'm going to let Ryan kind of kick off just how a day-to-day basis is going to go with what we're eating, how we're preparing for the day and getting our fuel for our workout. So
yeah, so basically I started CrossFit eating whatever I wanted. I was a college student, and then I kind of wanted to take CrossFit to a different level. So I drank the Kool-Aid and kind of and kind of started into the paleo diet, and I'm a firm believer that everybody's body responds to food differently, so not to say that the paleo diet is not a good diet or not a good structure to follow, but it definitely didn't work for me. I tried to follow it for about a year, and I'm kind of coming to realization of this now. I followed it for about a year, my body didn't really change. I guess my performance was a little bit better because I was watching when I was eating better quality foods, but the high fat, low carb definitely didn't play into my favor. So about 3 months ago, one of our members here, Lauren Zuli, she kind of pushed me in the direction of counting macros, which I kind of always almost made fun of, just because it's, in my eyes, yeah, it's just bodybuilding, you know, cutting and stuff like that. So started following that about 3 months ago. I've dropped about 15 pounds, and my performances and recovery has been through the roof. So I count my macros. I, you know, eat way more carbs than I was prior to starting counting, or in my paleo-ish phase. And it's kind of more flexible around eating and drinking and stuff like that. So that's what I do. I eat a lot of carbs at lunch and I eat a lot of carbs for dinner. I don't eat that many carbs in breakfast because I'm not going to use it throughout the day as if I were to be using them in here. So yeah, I'm kind of flexible dieting. The macro counting is what I follow now. But yeah, what do you do? I know what you do, but you tell these guys.
Yeah. So, do this thing. Coming back from collegiate football, I mean, I could eat whatever I wanted. I was upwards of 230 pounds at one point.
I was at 242 at my heaviest.
Hey,
and yeah. I weigh 218 now, so.
But that being said, I was like, I'm in the top 1%. I'm in my physical peak condition, performing at a high level. And then I broke my leg and then kind of took some time off. I lost a ton of weight. I got down, I think close to like 195 at one point, and then I found CrossFit about 2 years ago. And along that first year, I was still eating whatever I wanted because it worked for me in football. And you know, I got to a certain point where I was like, this is my peak physical condition. I didn't really need to expand my nutritional horizons. And then I started talking to a lot of people and they were surpassing me in their performances, their watt times and stuff like that, and their numbers, and I was just kind of like really doubting what's going on and
what are you doing?
What am I doing differently, or what are they doing differently that's kind of letting them surpass me in all these categories? And then the box that I was originally at, we did a 60-day paleo challenge. I tested the waters with that, and I saw great results, but I wasn't gaining any weight. For me, I'm at a healthy like 212 right now. But I was still right around that 195, 200 mark, but I was performing better, I was getting stronger, but it just wasn't where I wanted. And then I followed a pretty strict diet of just healthy, clean eating. And every once in a while I'd like to indulge on a pizza, which we still do on a weekend adventure, whatever we're doing. But just recently, kind of like the same story as Sam, but a lot recently, more recently, I started counting macros, upwards of like 4,500 calories a day with like the carbs when needed, proteins,
And I've noticed my performance has gone through the roof. I've gained healthy lean weight, and I'd say I'm a lot more conscious of when I'm having my cheat meals.
Even it's kind of weird because I always had the perspective of like counting macros is only for people who are getting on stage to show off a physique, when in reality you're really just being aware of what you're eating,
right,
and the quantities that you're eating. Like JJ, she, you know, she doesn't need to count necessarily speaking, but it helps her track her calories throughout the day so that she can peak in performance. I mean, it really can be tailored to anybody, whether you're trying to maintain your weight, lose weight, or gain weight.
And regardless of anything, I would just say, if you are questioned about your nutrition, it just kind of holds you accountable throughout the day of like what you're eating and stuff like that.
Even just write it down.
Yeah, you know, just write it down or something.
MyFitnessPal is super easy.
Yeah, we can probably tag that.
It's pretty. Everybody has probably heard of it anyway, so it's free. But yeah, let's wrap it up. I just want to say thank you for everybody that's actually been watching. I know this is starting very slow. Some of it might be boring. This might have been boring. You guys need to let us know like what you want to hear from us. And thanks to all the boxes in Grand Rapids for kind of just letting their members follow us if they do, all of our members for supporting us. We appreciate it. It's been fun. Yeah. I like it so far.
It's been fun, and we've talked about opening up a Twitter account where you guys can shoot questions at us, and we'll try to answer them probably, I'd say probably once a month, being that we're doing probably 4 to 5 of these a month. We'll just pick a day and kind of answer some questions, give you guys some feedback, so it's real interactive. I believe we're now live on Periscope as well, if you guys haven't checked that out. It's a pretty cool app where you can follow live feed of what we're kind of doing on a day-to-day basis. If you guys have any questions for the time being, leave it in the comment section, and we'll try to get back to you as soon as we can.
Other than that,
just...
Let's train. I gotta train.
Yep.
We gotta go. Bye.